वैकुंठाय विद्महे वैकुंठाय धीमहि तन्नो दन्ति प्रचोदयात् ॐ ईकदन्ताय विद्महे वैकुंठाय धीमहि तन्नो दन्ति प्रचोदयात् ॐ ईकदन्ताय विद्महे वैकुंठाय धीमहि तन्नो दन्ति प्रचोदयात् ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्ति। नमः शिवाय नमः शिवाय हर हर भोले नमः शिवाय
Bye. बन के कभी श्याम बन के चले आना प्रभु जी चले आना, कभी राम बन के कभी श्याम बन के चले आना प्रभु जी चले आना।
दाता एक राम, दाता एक राम, दाता एक राम, भिखारी सारी दुनिया दाता एक राम।
प्रेम से बोले श्रीमावती महादेव की जय। सीताराम डिवोटीज शुभ स्वागतम मुस्को जो वेलकम टू यू टुनाइट ऑन बिहाफ ऑफ द मैनेजमेंट कमिटी हियर एट द श्री गणेश मंदिर टू दिस थर्ड नाइट ऑफ डिवोशन ऑफ शिव पुराण यज्ञ वेयर वी हैव द वंडरफुल अपॉर्चुनिटी माय डियर फ्रेंड्स टू एक्सप्लोर एंड टू एक्सपाउंड द डिवाइन चरित्र ऑफ सदाशिव भगवान as taken from the pages of Shiva Mahapuran. At this point in time, khada ho jaye, let us all stand as we join together in Shivaji ki arati.
Sajam chavarshitam yuktam vahinayo jitam maya dipam grahan devasya trailokyam तिमरायपहम् जय शिवम कारा हर शिवम कारा जय शिवम कारा हर शिवम कारा सदा शिव अर्धांगी धारा ओम हर 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 महादेव जय शिव तारा हर शिव तारा चतुरानन पंचानन राजे हंसासन गरुरासन विश्वान साजय बोलो जय शिव तारा हर शिव तारा माला बन माला मुंड माला धारी चंदन मृग मर चंदा भाला शुभकारी बोलो जय शिव तारा हर शिव तारा प्रभुतागित भूतागित संगे बोलो जय शिव ओंकारा हर शिव ओंकारा ओ महाविष्णु सदाशिव जानत विवेका प्रणवाक्षर के मध्य यह तीनों एका बोलो जय शिव ओंकारा हर शिव ओंकारा
श्रीमापति महादेव की पवन सुत हनुमान की श्री वृंदावन बिहारीलाल की उड़ेसा जगन्नाथ की बोलो भाई सब संतन की सियापति रामचंद्र की जय आसन लीजिए kindly be seated devotees officiating pujari pandit pandit surendra maharaj pandit vinayak maharaj Shrutagan, Bhaktajan, devotees of God, once again tonight, Shubh Swagatam, a very special welcome to you on behalf of the management committee here at this beautiful Sri Ganesh Mandir. Tonight, as we prepare ourselves once more to delve into the pages of Shiva Mahapuran Katha, we firstly join together in dhyan, in meditation. As we stabilize our thoughts and focus our energies on that most wondrous, beauteous form of Sadashiv Bhagwan. And so, where we sit, we assume a most comfortable posture. We close our eyes and bring to our minds that most benevolent form of Shankar Bhagwan. We see him as he sits upon Kailash Parvat, at his side is Divine Mother Devi Parvati Mata, alongside Ganesh Bhagwan and Swami Kartikeya. We pray for the blessings of Sadashiv Bhagwan tonight and for the fulfillment of all goals and desires. Saraswatiye Namaha Shri Guru Charan Kamale Yo Namaha Om Pranam Shirsha Devam Gauri Putram Vasam smare nityam ayuh kam arth siddhaye vidyarambhe vivahe cha praveshe nirgame tatha sangrame sankate shaiva vighnatasya najayate Om Shweta Paramasanam Devim Shweta Pushpot Pashobhinim Shweta Amavardharam Nityam Shweta Gandhanolepanam Dhyanamulam Gurur Murti Pujamulam Gurur Param Mantramulam Gurur Vakyam Mokshamulam Gurur Param Adhyantarehte Devi Adishakti Maheshwari Yoga Jai Yoga Sambhute Mahalakshmi Namastute Bhadrakali Namo Nityam Sarve Shakti Swarupini Jagat Stite Jagan Mata Narayani Namastute Nagendra Haraya Trilochanaya Bhasmangaragaya Maheshwaraya Nityaya Shudhaya Digambaraya Tasmay Nakaraya Namah Shivaya Manjavan Maruta Tulya Vegam Jite Indriyam buddhi matam vavishtam Vatatmacham vanarayujamukhyam Shiramadutam sharanam prabadhe Rama Ramaya Rama Bhadraya Rama Chandraya Virse Raghunathaya Sitaye Pataye Namaha Yadevi Sarva Bhuteshu Durga Rupena Sanskrita Namaste
नमस्तसे 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 नमो नमः या देवी सर्वभूतेषु मातृरूपेण संस्थिता नमस्तसे 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 नमो नमः या देवी सर्वभूतेषु मातृरूपेण संस्थिता नमस्तसे 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 नमो नमः ओम शांति 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 हरि
We begin tonight by glorifying Shri Ganesh Bhagwan. Let us all dedicate our thoughts to that most benevolent Lord, Bhagwan Ganapati, as we pray for his blessings tonight and for the success of our devotions here this evening.
Jai Jai Gauri Pati Brijpati Jai Jai Sri Ganesh Namo Saraswati Sharda Mangal Karo सरस्वती सिकति पदांगी सब गुण अलकी
प्रेम से बड़े श्री गजानंद स्वामी की जय जय On the first night of this yagya, we started looking at the 108 names of Lord Shiva. Of course, we have gone through 40 of the names of Lord Shiva. Last night, we stopped at the 40th name, Loknath, which means he is the ruler of all the worlds, all the lokas. We live on Mrityu Lok, but there is Vaikunth Lok. There is Patal Lok, there is Yam Lok, and other Lokas. So when we describe him as Loknath, he is the ruler, my dear friends, or the lord of all the Lokas. And so we continue. Number 41, the 41st name, Mahakal, the destroyer of death. How is it possible that someone can be the destroyer of death? You and I, my dear friends, we are subjected to birth and to death. Whomever is born must die. But our divine Lord, Mahakal, my dear friends, he is the destroyer of death. That means he is not subjected to birth and death as you and I are subjected to birth and death. Mahamaya, which means he destroys the effects of Maya in the lives of his devotees. Maya, my dear friends, is delusion. It causes us to forget ourselves, our purpose, our place in this world. It causes us to forget that relationship between ourselves and God. You see, if we just say his name is Mahamaya, and we do not give the explanation of what Mahamaya really means, my dear friends, it is just another name. All our names has meanings. Take the time, my dear friends, to understand the meanings of the various names, you know, that is given to us. Of course, the good Hindu names, you know, sometimes we are going more in the Western influence. And we're giving our children, you know, nice names, Western names, but the Western names do not convey those deep philosophical and spiritual meanings of the Hindu names. So, Mahamaya means he's the destroyer of Maya and delusion in the lives of his devotees. Vagish means he's the lord of speech. Whilst we worship Saraswati Mata as a goddess of knowledge and of speech and so on, he, Shankar Bhagwan, also, my dear friends, blesses us with fluent speech. Shrikant, which means he who possesses that glorious throat. So he's also Nilkant, and we explained the meaning of this particular name on a previous night's katha. Nilkant, of course, when he ingested the poison, but also Shrikant, my dear friends, he who possesses that divine or glorious throat. And you know, when Baba has performed pujan, he offers the chandan, the tilak on the forehead, and of course by the ears, to bless the ears, and also on the throat, to bless the throat, so that we too, my dear friends, would be blessed with that divine and glorious truth that would, of course, enable us to utter glorious and divine words and speech. The words you speak, my dear friends, is an indication of who you are. And so, he who possesses that glorious or divine speech, my dear friends, is blessed by Lord Shiva. The 45th name, Suresh, that means he is the god of all the devis and devatas. 46th name, Mrigapati, or the lord of the deer, and by extension, the lord of all animals. Buddhadev, he is the god of earth, this earthly planet. He presides over this earthly planet. Whilst the other devis and devatas have their abode in Vaikunth Lok, Shankar Bhagwan has his abode upon Kailash Parvat. And where is Kailash Parvat, my dear friends? Right here on this earthly planet in India. So Buddhadev, he is the god of this earthly sphere. The 48th name, Durlabha, which means he's like a rare gem. Durlabha, he's that sacred lord, that rare gem amongst others. The 49th name, Jagadish, which means he's Lord of the universe. Now we say Jagdish. You know, if we have to name, we wouldn't say Jagadish. Jagadish is a proper name and a proper pronunciation. You know, like when we say Devaraj, Devaraj is really Devaraj. You know, the king of the Devas, Devaraj. But in our writing and spelling and normal calling on a day-to-day basis, we say Devaraj. And in this word, this name as well, Jagadish, my dear friends, the Lord of the entire universe, the 50th name, Vyalin, or he who is surrounded by serpents. Of course, Nag Devata is seen around his neck, my dear friends. And so Vyalin means he's surrounded by serpents. The 51st name, Stiapar, which means he who is devoted to truth or Satyam. At all times, he says to us, we as well must maintain satyam or truthfulness in our lives. 52nd name is Anand, which means blessed and always filled with happiness and joy. The 53rd name, Jitendriya, conqueror of the senses, he who is unaffected, my dear friends, by the lures of the senses. You and I are subjected to the influences of our senses, you know, because of the lure of the carnival, you know, carnival and Shivratri, and that's the test right there, my dear friends. Always comes together, always there's some overlap. These two occasions are celebrated close together. And my dear friends, as we well know, while the majority of our Hindu brothers and sisters would stay away from the carnival and of course would indulge only in the Shivratri and of course would engage in fasting and so on, yet we know others are lured away, my dear friends, by the temptations on the other side. So Jitendriya means that we too must be by like Lord Shiva and also conquer, my dear friends, the senses. Paramatman, or the great soul, we strive to be like him as well, my dear friends. The 55th name of Lord Shiva, Jagat Guru, or the Guru of the entire universe. Whilst we have, you know, our earthly Guru, the Vidya Guru, who would impart to us the Guru Mantra and perform the Guru Mukhsanskar and so on. Yet, Lord Shiva is Jagat Guru. He is the Guru of all Gurus. Meaning, my dear friends, that, you know, as you read the Shiv Puran from night to night, as you listen to the glories of Shiva Mahapuran, so many lessons comes to us from Lord Shiva. As we interpret the names of Lord Shiva, each name has a lesson, each name has a message. All of these lessons, my dear friends, are being given to us by Jagat Guru, Shankar Bhagwan. Kamandaludhar, which means he is the beggar, he is the bearer of the Kamandal. What is the Kamandal? My dear friends, the Kamandal is like the lota, except, you know, thousands of years ago, there would be a little handle on the lota and making it a Kamandal. When the rishis and munis would go about in the forest and they're performing tapasya and so on, this was their the vessel with which they would take the water from place to place. So Kamandaludhar means he is the bearer of that Kamandal, or he who always have that Kamandal with him. Anadi, having no beginning, having no birth. And he who has no birth and no beginning, then of course there is no end or no death. And this of course is symbolized by the Trishul and the Shivlingam, which means that he is without beginning or end. The 58th name of Lord Shiva, Lokpal, or the protector of this entire universe. The 59th name, Anagha, which means he is faultless. You and I are subjected to making faults and mistakes, but that Divine Lord is perfect. We are imperfect beings, but he, of course, is the most perfect amongst all. And so he is also known as Anag, or he who is faultless. And his 60th name, Param Tapas, or he who performs the most difficult tapas or tapasya. And of course, upon Kailash Parvat, my dear friends, he would often sit, you know, in the performance of tapasya. And he, you know, explained to Parvati Mata one time, for because she asked him, "My Lord, here I am sitting next to you, but you have spent so many days and so many weeks and months in tapasya whilst I'm here at your side." And he explained to her, Devi Parvati, to generate that divine shakti that keeps this universe going, to protect my bhaktas, my devotees, I engage in tapasya to generate that energy to sustain this entire universe. And so, my dear friends, when we as well would perform our devotion to Bhagwan, whenever you sit at the bedi to perform puja, you come to the yajna here and listen to Bhagwan's katha and so on, you too are generating a certain amount of spiritual energy. You know, there's a physical energy, be it the roti and talkari and kari and rice and so on. That's for physical sustenance. But Bhagwan is saying to us, the spiritual energy is also important. For sometimes even as the physical energy fades away, my dear friends, the spiritual energy takes over. You know, those who engage in fasting and so on regularly will tell you, you know, 9 days of Navratri would pass by without consuming a single mouthful of food. And people wonder how they do it. Long after, my dear friends, all the physical nutrients and so on has drained away from this body, it is that spiritual energy that would keep us going. And this is what he had explained to Parvati Mata. This tapasya I perform, O Devi Parvati, gives to me that energy, that divine shakti, to bestow my blessings upon my devotees.
Samay kaik tara jab bole, jal thal nabh mein madhu ras bole. Yeah. पतित पावन नाम है उसका, उसके नाम की जल से जीवन की सजरिया धोले। ओम नमः शिवाय।
So we turn our attention to Katha tonight. We read tonight, my dear friends, the manifestation of Kal Bhairav. Bhairav Baba is looked upon as an avatar of Sadashiv Bhagwan. We shall find out under what circumstances did Lord Shiva take Kal Bhairav avatar. For what purpose was this avatar taken?
शिवाय नमः शिव शिवाय नमः शिव शिवाय नमो नमः शिवाय।
सबको ही
शिवाय नमः शिव शिवाय नमः शिव शिवाय नमो नमः शिवाय। शिवाय नमः शिव शिवाय नमः शिव शिवाय नमः शिव शिवाय नमः शिव शिवाय नमो नमः शिवाय। शिवाय नमो नमः शिवाय।
सुचुजी महाराज बोले हे मुनीश्वर सुचुजी महाराज addresses this beautiful katha of Bhairav Baba to Shaunam Muni and other 88,000 rishis and munis gathered together in the Naimisharanya forest.
एक तो काल भैरव भूतों से भी जिनके अधीन सर्व योगीनाथ में और जो सर्व संसार को भयानक दृष्टि पाने उसका नाम काल भैरव शिव शंकर भगवान अवतार किया। उन्होंने भैरव बाबा भी यह और कोई भैरव का और किस प्रकार कार्य को निमित्र उपजे थे यह सब वृतांत आप मुझे सुनाए। यह बात कुंभज मुनि से सुनकर स्कंद मुनि बोले कि भैरव सदाशिव जी भगवान पूर्ण रूप होते हैं, तो वे भूतों भी और भयानक की सपना को आप ही सदाशिव जी भगवान जिनको मूर्ख लोग नहीं जानते, किंतु ब्रह्म और विष्णु भगवान इतनी महिमा सकते हैं। यह कुछ कुछ अचरज की बात नहीं सुनते हैं, वरन भी शिवजी भगवान माया रूप माया नहीं सकती है। एक समय सब देवता लोग मुनि आरी इकट्ठी बैठकर विराजमान तपने सबको वृतांत होकर कहने लगी कि चले मारु पर्वत को, तत्पश्चात स्तुति अनंतर पूछा महाराज आप भी सुनाते हैं कि कौन है कौन सा दोष रहित अविनाशी सबको जाने वालों निर्गुण और सर्वगुण संसार स्वामी परमेश्वर अत्यंत रहते हैं। शिवाय नमः शिव शिवाय नमः शिव शिवाय नमो नमः शिवाय शिवाय नमः शिव शिवाय नमः शिव शिवाय नमो नमः शिवाय शिवाय नमो शिवाय शिवाय नमो नमः शिवाय।
प्रेम सुमुनि श्रमापति महादेव की जय। The devatas had gone to Lord Brahma. They had asked several questions of him. Who is Nirgun aur Sagun? Who is with form? Who is without form? It is said that Divine Lord is both form and formless. That is to say, He has taken all these numerous forms that you see before you, beautifully depicted in all the murtis, as Bhagwan Ganapati, as Bhagwan Shankar, as Lord Krishna, Sri Ramchandra, and all of the other numerous murtis. So that is the formless, that part of Bhagwan who manifests in all of these various forms, yet he is without form. So they are asking, who is that Divine Lord who is both Nirgun aur Sagun? Who is that Divine Lord who is indestructible? Which is that Lord who is unborn and who will not die? Who is that Divine Lord that supports this entire universe? Tell us, O Parampita Brahmaji, who is that Divine Lord? And so he says to them, let us go to Lord Vishnu. Perhaps Lord Vishnu would be able to enlighten us. And so, my dear friends, they go to the Kshirsagar, to the Milky Ocean, where Lord Vishnu is reclining upon Sheshnag, the divine serpent. They pay their respects to Bhagwan Vishnu, and they ask him as well the very same question. Who is the Lord that caused the origin of this universe, the creator of this universe? Who is that Lord who would dissolve this entire universe? Who is that Lord who is both with form and also who is formless? And so, my dear friends, a great discussion is now ensuing amongst the devatas. Who would be able to shed light on all of these answers? And indeed, my dear friends, these very same questions may have entered into our minds from time to time. What was there at the beginning of creation? You know, the discussion amongst Lord Brahma,
Lord Vishnu and all the Devta Log who have assembled there, my dear friends, this discussion is continuing. What was there at the time of creation? There were no earthly planet. There were no trees. There were no mountain. There were no forests. Who initiated all of these energies? What energy was given to start all of this creation? And of course, it takes a massive amount of energy to begin, initiate, my dear friends, creation in this manner. And as they are asking all of these questions, and as they are discussing amongst themselves, my dear friends, before them manifested Shankar Bhagwan, not in the form of Lord Shiva, as we see him in the Murti, but my dear friends, in that jyotir ling, what is described in Shiv Puran here as that stump or that pillar of light. They were all amazed. Devotees, to see this massive jyotir ling, this massive pillar of light described here as that stump, my dear friends, growing before them. As far as they could see, above, there was no end to this jyotir ling. As far as they could see beneath them, still there was no end to this massive stump or this pillar of light. They were mystified. How could this be manifested before us? Which force, which energy has brought forth this massive pillar of light? And so Lord Brahma says, fear not, I will journey upwards to find where it has begun. And Lord Vishnu says, I will journey downwards to find where it has ended. And they say to the Devatas, Devata Log, you remain right here. We will report to you shortly. You know, the beginning or end, we must detect, you know, who has the power to create such a magnificent pillar of light. And so, my dear friends, so saying, Lord Brahma departed, Lord Vishnu departed, Lord Brahma goes, Akash, towards the heavens, my dear friends, Uparvala. And of course, Lord Vishnu descends, my dear friends, into the nether regions to find out where this began. After many, many months, and this will tell you, my dear friends, that this pillar of light spans all the lokas, what are called the planets. Today, of course, massive space shuttles would be built, and you would read, my dear friends, that the astronauts journey for many months before they could reach the moon, Chandrama. You know, and yet again they are trying to journey towards the sun and the other planets, my dear friends. Here we are reading in Shiv Puran Katha that both Lord Vishnu and Lord Brahma are performing space travel. For many months they are journeying upwards and downwards, my dear friends, trying to find out where this jyotir ling has gotten its energy, where it begins and where it ends. And so finally, after a very long wait, they return to the Devatas, who by this time are getting anxious. Having waited so long, my dear friends, they're relieved to finally see Lord Vishnu and Lord Brahma returning to them. And Lord Vishnu says, I have journeyed as far as it is possible to journey, and I have not seen where this stump, this pillar of light, this jyotir ling has begun. Lord Brahma is thinking to himself, he too has the same answer, my dear friends. He too has been unsuccessful in negotiating, in discovering where this jyotir ling originated. And despite the fact that he has failed to discover, just as Lord Vishnu has failed to discover the origin of this jyotir ling, yet, my dear friends, he speaks an untruth. Jhoot bolta hai. He's lying, my dear friends, and he says yes to Lord Vishnu and to all the others who are there. Yes, I have found the origin. I have found the source of this massive jyotir ling. My dear friends,
this inability of Lord Brahma to speak the truth. At that point in time, I should tell you, Lord Brahma had 5 heads, 5 mukhi. And we shall find out in a short while what happened to that 5th head that spoke the lie. Satyam, or truth, honesty, my dear friends, is one of the pillars of Sanatan Dharma. We are taught to be truthful, to be honest at all times. Even in Ramayana Katha, Raja Dashrath, Raghukula Tilaka Janapur Vahi Jai Ram Shri Rama Jai Jai Rama Shri Rama Jai Rama Jai Jai Rama. He says, I prefer to give up this life than to speak an untruth. So whether it's Ramayana Katha you read, Shiv Puran Katha you read, that lesson, my dear friends, of always being truthful and honest is emphasized. So here, Lord Brahma, my dear friends, speaking this untruth, reveals to Lord Brahma, to Lord Vishnu, and to the other devatas who are there, that yes, I have found the origin, the source of this Jyotirlinga. It is revealed here in Shiv Puran Katha on account of the Abhiman, my dear friends, that entered into his mind just for one moment. He spoke this untruth. This is why, my dear friends, you know, whilst we have so many murtis of all the various devis and devatas, no murti of Lord Brahma is depicted. In many mandirs you would go to, you would not find the murti of Lord Brahma. And the reason, my dear friends, is found right here in this katha tonight of Kal Bhairav. This untruth that he has spoken.
मत कर तू अभिमान रे बंदे झूठी तेरी शान रे मत कर तू अभिमान मत कर तू अभिमान रे बंदे झूठी तेरी शान रे मत कर तू
जप ले हरि का नाम रे बंदे
नाच कर तू अभिमान बन दे ज्योति तेरी शान रे नाच कर तू
When that untruth was spoken by Lord Brahma, Lord Shiva manifested from that Jyotirling, Kal Bhairav Baba. In this form of Kal Bhairav, he approached Lord Brahma, and that fifth head, remember we said at that time, Lord Brahma was depicted as having five heads, Panch Mukhi. One of the head had spoken the untruth. Bhairav Baba manifesting, Lord Shiva manifesting in the form of Kal Bhairav, my dear friends, approached Lord Brahma and severed, he cut off the fifth head. From that point in time, Lord Brahma has always been shown, my dear friends, with four heads representing the four Vedas. That fifth head of Lord Brahma, my dear friends, represented the five senses. We have five senses sometimes, my dear friends, which also causes us from time to time to also step out, my dear friends, out of the dharmic parameters within which we are supposed to operate. Sometimes, my dear friends, in certain circumstances, that tendency to speak that falsehood may also come to us, perhaps to get out of a difficult situation. Just as Lord Brahma, my dear friends, has spoken this falsehood and he has suffered now the consequences of lying. My dear friends, from time to time, we as well may be inclined, we may be tempted, my dear friends, and here the example of speaking a lie is given, but there are many other ways in which our senses of sight, seeing, hearing, tasting, touch and smell, my dear friends, these five senses of which we are supposed to be their masters, sometimes, my dear friends, may also incite us and rule us you know, overcome us in a particular manner and take us away from the feet of Lord Shiva. So the lesson is very clear. That sense, my dear friends, whichever it is, that causes us to get off course, off that pathway of dharma, Bhagwan is saying to us, we must subdue that sense. And so just as Kal Bhairav have severed that fifth head of Lord Brahma, representing, symbolizing, my dear friends, the ability of the senses to also control us, Bhagwan is saying that we must in a similar manner get rid of that influence. Instead of the senses being our master, we become the master of our senses. Chanchal manava bhajle Ram Shri Ram ka chanchal manava bhajle Ram Shri Ram ka. The mind becomes very chanchal when the senses, my dear friends, become unruly, when we are unable to rein in. You know, if you ever look at the picture of Surya Narayan Swami, you would see him seated on the chariot. There's a charioteer there, and the horses are pulling the chariot. The horses represent the senses. When the charioteer has the reins in his hands, he would indicate to the horses he wants to go to the left, he wants to go to the right, or he wants to go straight ahead. Can you imagine what would happen to that chariot if the reins fell out of his hands? Then, my dear friends, each horse, one may pull to the left, one may pull to the right, and easily that chariot would go off course. This is what happens to our lives, my dear friends. We become derailed. We go off course when we do not have the reins to the senses in our hands. When we are not in control, my dear friends, we too go off course and we allow the senses, my dear friends, to take us to places that we are not supposed to be going. To eat things we are not supposed to be eating. To drink things we are not supposed to be drinking. To say things, as Lord Brahma has done, that we are not supposed to be saying. Be in control of the senses. This is the wonderful lesson, my dear friends, that Kal Bhairav Baba is given to us. So the moment that falsehood, that lie was spoken, my dear friends, Kal Bhairav Baba appeared, manifesting out of that jyotid ling that Lord Brahma said, yes, I found out the origin, I know where it started. Whereas just like Lord Vishnu says, I could not find the beginning. You know, it's a very simple thing, you know. If you don't have the ability to do something, say you don't have the ability to do something. If you cannot do it, say you cannot do it. Instead of what often happens, my dear friends, all the lies that takes place sometimes. And so immediately that fifth head was severed by Kal Bhairav Baba, symbolizing, my dear friends, that he is there to destroy all negativities, all impurities, all tendencies that take us away from Bhagwan and our devotion to Bhagwan. Kal Bhairav also symbolizes that he is the master of Kal. Kal means time. He is the master or the controller of time. Unknown to us, my dear friends, time also controls us. There's a time of birth. There's a time of death. There's a time for the children to go to school and come back from school. There's a time for us to start devotion here in the yajna, and there's a time for us to conclude devotion here at the yajna. There's a time to go to sleep and a time to wake up from sleep. There's a time for sunrise and a time for sunset. There's a time for the seasons, the rainy season, the dry season.
Everything, my dear friends, is controlled by time. So inadvertently, time controls, my dear friends, all of us. All of us are subjected, my dear friends, to Kal Bhairav and the influence that time has upon all of us. And so when we pray to Bhairav Baba, my dear friends, we pray for his blessing so that we too would develop that mastery over time. Time well spent, my dear friends, becomes our greatest asset. Time is like the sped arrow. It never comes back to you. This day you would not have again. This month you would not have again. This year you would not have again. Make best use of this time that Bhagwan has given to us.
Umar ka panchi urta jata.
And this bhajan tells us about time. Just as the bird would sit before you, or you perched upon the branch, it would take off in flight and disappear into the horizon. So too our life. One moment we in the childhood days of our lives, and before we know it, my dear friends, we become much advanced in age.
Aaj kahe kal naam ratunga, kal aaye phir kal japlunga.
What you must do today, do not put it off for tomorrow, for you're not sure about tomorrow. The time that Bhagwan has given to us is now. Make best use of this time. The lessons of Kal Bhairav Baba.
Umar ka panchi urta jata. Kyun prani prabhu naam lagata re. Umar ka panchi, umar ka panchi.
You have
चर्चा जाता
So Bhairav Baba, my dear friends, is waiting. In the case of Lord Brahma, he used, my dear friends, that sword to sever the head of Lord Brahma. In our case, my dear friends, that sword of time is waiting for us. And just as the sword that he used, my dear friends, against Lord Brahma, changed Lord Brahma. From being Panchmukhi to Chautmukhi or four-faced, my dear friends. So too when Kal Bhairav administers that sword of time against us, my dear friends, we too are altered. We too are changed, my dear friends, in who we are and what we are.
Chalti chakki dekh ke साबत बचाना कोई चलती चक्की देख के
and that's a beautiful bhajan where it connects beautifully with this katha.
He says just as a saw in the sawmill would transform the log from one entity, from one whole, into several pieces of board. And if you have ever gone to the sawmill, you would notice what happens. The log, my dear friends, comes up to a massive saw. And what it was before, it went through the saw, is different to what it is after, when it comes onto the other side of the saw. Of course, before it was one log. When it comes out on the other side of the log, my dear friends, it is several pieces of board. We too are going through the saw of time. Kal Bhairav, my dear friends, is administering that saw of time upon all of us. If you look at yourself when you were 5 years old and you look at who you are now, you will look totally different. If you look at yourself when you're 25 years old and who you are now, you would see that Kal Bhairav, Kal, that saw of time, has already taken that effect, my dear friends, upon us. And the final blade is inflicted upon us, my dear friends, marne ke samay, at the time of death. What happens when that final stroke of time is inflicted upon us, my dear friends? Who we become? We become a handful of ashes. We are placed upon the chita, upon the pyre, and when the fire has finished with us, and when Kal Bhairav has finished with us, my dear friends, this, just as the log, you know, was transformed into four or five pieces of board, this entire body is transformed into a bucket of ashes, which is taken and offered into the water. So Kal Bhairav, my dear friends, acts
upon all of us, just as he acted upon Lord Brahma, removing that head. Jhoot bolta hai, never speak on truth, always speak the truth, always be honest at all times. This is a wonderful lesson, my dear friends. But there was a problem. Lord Shiva appeared. He says, Bhairav Baba, you have done well. You have corrected Lord Brahma. But violence must never be used to correct. Even when someone does something wrong, even when a lie is uttered, you should have found another way of bringing discipline to Lord Brahma. And so he says, to repent for this sin that you have committed. You see, my dear friends, no one is above the laws of karma. Lord Shiva is saying to us, yes, Kal Bhairav, you did well. You disciplined him, but you should find another way of bringing that discipline to him. And so no one is exempted from the laws of karma. You too have to perform prayaschit, penance, for acting in this violent manner. Take this head of Lord Brahma and circumambulate the universe. When you have done so, you will be redeemed of this sin that you have committed. And so, my dear friends, Bhairav Baba took off on this journey. It is described here that a female began to follow him. Lord Shiva created Bhairavi, which is the Shakti aspect of Kal Bhairav, the companion of Kal Bhairav. And so Kal Bhairav is followed by Bhairavi, and they undertake this circumambulation of the universe. And when he returned to Kailash, my dear friends, the head that he was holding in his hand, that he had severed from Lord Brahma, disappeared. This means that that prayaschit, that penance he had performed, had the effect of removing, my dear friends, that bharkaram that he had incurred when he severed the head of Lord Brahma. Prem Simuli Shruma Pati Mahadev Ki Jai, Shri Bhairav Baba Ki Jai. Jai 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 Shiva Avinashi Jai 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 Shiva Avinashi Jai 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 Shiva Avinashi
सन्यासी भगत व्यापी परम प्रतापी
सत सत व्यापी परम प्रतापी आय से वर्ष पर सुर नर सन्यासी
Mahadev ki jai. And so my dear friends, without us knowing it, Kal Bhairav makes that impact upon us every single day of our lives. Our devotion to Lord Shiva assists us, my dear friends, in ensuring that the effect or the impact of Kal Bhairav in our lives would always be positive. अच्छा खड़ा हो जाए लेट्स ऑल स्टैंड स्विच ऑन टुगेदर इन भगवान शंकर जी की आरती
साजं च वर्षितं युक्तं वहिनायोजितं मय दीपं ग्रहान देवस्य तैलोक्यं इन्द्रानुपहं आरती करो हर हर
शंकर की। This brings us to an end for devotion here tonight. Let us bow our heads in this final prayer. We give thanks to that divine Lord, Shankar Bhagwan, it is for your blessings, O Prabhu. We have come together tonight in this third night of Shiva Mahapuran Yagya. As we pray, we pray that you would place your protective hands upon us. May you, O Lord, continue to safeguard us and protect us against all dangers and difficulties. With utmost reverence, O Prabhu, we repeatedly surrender onto your lotus-like feet. Mantrahinam kriyahinam bhaktihinam janadhanam yatpujitam mayadevam paripurnam tadastu.
त्वमेव माता च पिता त्वमेव त्वमेव बन्धुश्च सखा त्वमेव त्वमेव विद्या द्राविणं त्वमेव त्वमेव सर्वं मम देव देव ॐ शान्ति 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 हरि ओम
प्रेम से बोले श्री गजानंद स्वामी की उमापति महादेव की पवन सुत हनुमान की श्री वृंदावन बिहारी लाल की उदय सा जगन्नाथ की बोलो भाई सब संतन की सियापति रामचंद्र की इन लाउड टोन वॉइस व्हिच आर फिक्स्ड विद टुवर्ड धर्म श्री सत्य सनातन धर्म की जय जय सीताराम आसन लीजिए कैन यू बी सीटेड डिवोटीज
गणपति गणेश भगवान की जय सीताराम डियर व्यूअर्स जॉइन मी पंडित विजय कुमार महाराज एज वी जॉइन टुगेदर इन पूजा डेडिकेटेड टू लॉर्ड गणेश एज वी